see Carson's first breath.
Oh, you did.
come into your house and worship you. We're thankful to be called your children, Father, and we just lift your name today, Father, and just hope that you will be pleased with this service. Father, we love you. We're thankful for your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Please be with us now and help us to be attentive to the words that you bring to Pastor Greg and to the words of the songs that we sing. Father, open our hearts and minds. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Take a moment and greet someone next to you. Look around and feel in all the empty seats.
Every breath. us through this life. Lord, we thank you that we don't have to go through this life alone and fearful and always discouraged and confused and wondering what's happening and wondering where we're going. We thank you, Lord, that you give us your light and your love and your truth. And we thank you, Father, that you put your Son Jesus within us and the Holy Spirit within us, and you walk alongside of us, and you take us by the hand, and you lead us. And we thank you for that this morning. We're here to praise you and to worship you and to honor your holy name. Father, as we look around the world and we see the needs that we have, we pray for our president and our government, that you would work in all those situations to bring honor to your name, to bring peace to the land. Father, we pray as we go to the election polls this next week that you would help us to vote with biblical values in mind, seeking your direction and your wisdom so that we might truly be a people under God. Lord, we just pray that you bring revival and renewal to this country and renewal to us and to this congregation. And just draw us close to you so that we might be your people, shining your light and your love in this world. Father, whatever needs, whatever issues, whatever problems we have today, we just lay them at your feet. Father, we pray for Amy DeFord, who has fallen recently and is hurt. We ask that you just touch her and heal her and draw her close to you, Lord, and meet her needs. Father, we just know that you're bigger and greater than any problem that we have. And rather than focusing on our problems today, we focus on you. And we bring our problems and our needs to you. And we ask that you would stretch forth your mighty hand and help us, give us answers, give us wisdom, give us guidance. Give us your healing touch. And Lord, wherever we're displeasing to you, whatever sins, whatever faults, wherever we may go astray, Lord, we ask that you would just place your finger upon that area in our lives, whether it's an attitude, whether it's a relationship, whether it's an action, whatever it is, Father, shine your light upon us and purify us and cleanse us and draw us close to you so that we might be a people that will bring you honor and glory. And all God's people say, amen. You may be seated. And at this time, I ask Chris and Lori Waits to bring their son Carson and Steve and Jen Benninger to bring their son Luke and also the families with them that they've asked to come forward. One of my favorite Bible verses. Are you okay over here? One of my favorite Bible verses is Genesis 1:31, where it says, God saw all that he had made, and behold, it was very good. You know, the Bible tells us, obviously, that God created life. The whole idea of a man and a woman and love and marriage and sexuality and children, it's good. It's God's idea. One day, Jesus and his disciples were busy ministering to the crowds, and the parents wanted to bring their little ones to Jesus and have him lay his hands on them and bless them and pray over them. And the disciples, his own 12, said, take these kids away. Jesus is too important. He's too busy. He doesn't have time for these kids. And the Bible says that Jesus rebuked them. He chewed them out and said, I love the little children. Let them come to me, for as such is the kingdom of God. Today, Steve and Jen and Chris and Lori want to bring their sons to Jesus. And they want to dedicate Carson and Luke to the Lord. And they want to dedicate themselves to this long process of raising a child in the ways of the Lord. Here at Clarkson Community, we do not baptize our babies and infants, but we dedicate them. We believe that the Bible teaches that there'll come a time when little Luke and little Carson will come of age, and they'll hear the gospel message for themselves, and they'll respond with faith in Jesus Christ. And when they make that commitment to become a disciple of Jesus Christ, at that time, they'll be baptized. But today, we are dedicating them to the Lord, asking God to bless them and protect them and guide them. And the parents and families are dedicating themselves to bringing their children up in the ways of the Lord. Chris and Lori, Steve and Jen, in presenting your sons in dedication to God, do you promise to model the love of Christ to Luke and Carson? Do you dedicate yourselves this day that you will intentionally teach them the truths of God so that they might grow to know God and obey God? Do you, as Luke's and Carson's grandparents and aunts and uncles, dedicate yourselves today to demonstrate godly love to one another and to Luke and Carson so that they might experience the love of God in their lives? Do you, the congregation, covenant with God to produce a Christian community for Luke and Carson and for all of our children so that they might see the power and presence of the Lord at work in their lives?
Amen.
Join me in prayer as I pray. And I'll pray for each other. I'll pray for Carson. He's covered all over the coat. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this bundle of joy, this bundle of life that you've blessed Chris and Lori with. Father, we lift up little Carson to you this morning. And we ask in Jesus' name that you would just protect him from all evil and all harm, that you would guide him, and even now touch him with your Holy Spirit, so that as he grows, he would be tender and open to you and receptive to the truths that Chris and Lori and their families and his church will teach them in the years ahead. We pray that you would just bless them, give Chris and Lori wisdom and guidance and how to guide little Carson. Give them patience, give them love. And Lord, I pray that you just wrap their whole family with your arms and fill them with your love so that little Carson can grow and glorify you. In Jesus' name, amen. A little Luke. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we also pray for Luke this morning. Lord, we thank you again for this gift of life. You have blessed Steve and Jen, and you've been at work in their lives, and we thank you for this, Lord. And Father, we pray that you would protect little Luke and just bless him with your Holy Spirit. Do a work in his heart even this morning that none of us can understand, but you do. And we ask that you would just open him and tender him so that he might be responsive to you in the years ahead. Lord, we don't know the future for Luke, but you do. We know that you already have a design, a plan, a purpose for his life. And we pray that you protect him from all evil and from the schemes of the evil one. And that as he grows, that he would not only hear about you and hear about your love, but that he would experience it personally. That he would experience you, and that he would come to have a personal walk with you. Lord, I pray for Steve and Jen, that you would give them wisdom and patience and counsel and guidance as they do their best to bring little Luke up in the ways of the Lord. Father, we ask that today you just place your blessing upon him and bring glory to your name through his life in the years and decades ahead. In Jesus' name we pray. He's a wrestler. He had my call. Stay right here. We want to sing a song and present you with some things. Angels fly,
wonderful as you. Every prayer and wish came true. I dreamed of you before I knew your name. I'm thankful for you. You know I name every day this week. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.